We're going to talk about coin flipping. Let's say you've got two people. You've got person A, person B, right? They're flipping coins. Let's say one of them is flipping coins and waiting for heads to turn up, right? So they're going to make a sequence of coin flips and they're waiting for heads. Person B, he's doing it and he's waiting for tails. So one of them is waiting for heads and one of them is waiting for tails. Now, what's the probability that you're going to get heads? I mean, even Brady would probably know this. What's the probability you get heads?
Oh, is it 1 in 4?
Yeah, exactly. So it's 1 in 4, and heads-tails, it's the same, right? So it's 1 in 4. Even though they have equal probability, I claim your average waiting time for heads is going to be longer than for heads. Let's do it. I mean, let's do the experiment. Let's not just write out mathematical formula. Let's do it. Okay. I'm going to flip this coin. Now we're going to do an average. I want to do a long sequence, and then we're going to see what the average is. So if I flip this coin, let's say 50 times, which is a nice long number, then we'll be able to take an average of how long we have to wait for heads or heads tails. Right, so if we do this, this is going to take me ages, isn't it? So instead of flipping this one coin 50 times, what I can do is I can flip 50 coins all at once, all right? Which I've just done there. Okay, the first coin is a tails. All right, second coin is, without looking, it's a heads. All right, next coin is tails. So I'm gonna do a sequence like that. Not even looking. We've run out of space, we better do another. Let's make them random. Right, so I pulled them out. I tried not to look at them, so it should be a sequence of random coin flips. I'll better write out so we can see what they are a bit better. Tail, head, tail, head, tail, and a head, and a tail, and a tail. Tail, head, tail. All right. We're going to look at this sequence, and we're going to play the game. We're tossing a sequence of coins, and we're waiting to see how long we have to wait for head, tail. If I start here, I'm looking for a head tail. Oh, there it is, right. All right, that's my first head tail there. That was a waiting time of 3. And then I got head tail. And then I start again. Okay, I do a new game. I'm gonna look for head tail. And I had to wait 1, 2, 3, 4. There it is. And I'm gonna do it again. Oh, look, this one is straight away. Look, head tail. Now I'm gonna start again. I'm looking for head tail. Oh, this is a long wait here. And then there it is, head tail. And oh, head tail there. There it is. Oh, and there's one right at the end as well. Right, what was the average waiting time? Let's have a look at the waiting time. So that's about an average wait of 4.5. Let's look at the heads though. You would have to wait, how long? Oh, this is a long waiting time here. It happens all the way over here. There, heads, which was a long wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So you've played a game and it ends when you get heads. Great, done. So now we start a new game, a completely different game from this point on. So we'll just start again. Oh, but this time, notice that the heads comes up really quickly. Look at that. It's just straight away, look, 2. And now we start a new game. Okay, so we had a success. We'll start a new game and we have to wait 1, 2, 3. Let's look for our average waiting time for heads. Okay, which is 7, right? And yes, oh look, yes. You have a longer average waiting time for heads than you do for heads, even though they have an equal probability. They're both 1/4. Why is this? You can kind of see what that reason is from this sequence. Because if you noticed when we were doing it, when you play heads-tails, you know, you get heads-tails, then you start a new game, and you wait for heads-tails, and you start a new game. Heads-heads was slightly different. When we did it with heads-heads, look what happened here. When you have something like this, heads-heads, heads-heads, we have this overlap. And this overlap isn't counted. We were playing it until we got heads-heads, and then the game stopped. And then we play a new game from that point. So here we've got a heads-heads that didn't get counted as a heads. So if you look at how many heads we've got, it should be about an equal number to heads, but the overlaps don't get counted. I mean, let's just check. So how many heads did we have? Well, actually, no, we got 11. I know for a fact we've got 11. How many heads did we have, including the overlaps? One here, we have 2, we have 3. So if you actually count up the heads, we had 9 of them, but only 6 were included in our waiting time average. So this sequence, we were looking at what would happen for consecutive values. So, you know, heads, heads, tails. And the same sort of thing would happen with tails, heads, and tails, tails. We're looking at consecutive values. In fact, the reason I mentioned this is because if you remember, there was that prime news where they were looking at primes and the ending of primes for consecutive primes. This is what they were looking for. They thought, oh, if primes are random like coin flips, I'm going to find this effect. What turned out to be the case is that they didn't find this effect because the primes weren't being random like coins. If you did this forever, if you had a sequence that just went on to infinity, the average waiting time then is, I'll show you what that is. It's called expectation or expected waiting time. The expected waiting time for head tails is equal to 4, which kind of makes sense when it's a quarter probability. That does make sense. And then the expected waiting time for heads is longer, and it's 6. So we were close, but just a little bit off. And if you wanted the expected waiting time for tails, well, that's 6 as well. That's just the same idea.
Audible's ever-growing collection of books and other spoken material has now reached in the order of 250,000 titles. So no matter what you're interested in, Audible's bound to have multiple options for you. Now, I spend a lot of time driving, as you can see here, often in the UK's delightful traffic, and there are few better ways to pass the time than listening to audiobooks. You can have something entertaining, something educational, or maybe a bit of both. The choice is yours. I particularly enjoy books about mountaineering. These titles here about Mount Everest are all very good. I'll put their details in the description, along with this one about K2, which is one of my favourites as well. And that's just a fraction of the mountaineering books on Audible. I told you, they've got something for everyone. If you'd like to give them a try, go to audible.com/numberphile and you can sign on for their free 30-day trial. That trial includes your first book, and as I said, there are plenty to choose from. That address again, audible.com/numberphile, so they'll know you came from our channel, which is handy for us. And then the free trial for 30 days. Our thanks to Audible for supporting this episode of Numberphile.
Maths works. Maths just works. It's wonderful that way, how maths just works out.
Every time.
Every time, just how you want it to work out. Especially with the power of editing.
What happened?
We did our first take and we got the opposite result from what we wanted.
It's done, yeah.
48 over 11, which is the opposite of what I said. And we have to film the whole thing again, right?